Hello everyone, welcome and hi. This is Pastor Dennis from Hope Kuching, and I would like to bring you some interesting news and updates that's happening in HIM family. Many of us remembered Global Fest in March of this year, and there are so many encouraging reports and feedback, and people are really eager to come together again. So the good news is, in September of this year, we're going to have the Global Equip 21. During this time in September, we have a few programs and meetups for different ones. The first one is the Global Prayer. This will be happening from the 12th to the 16th of September. And we do invite everyone to fast and pray together as a HIM family. Daily prayer points will be published on our social media, and every day at a certain time, which you can check in the information, we will have Facebook Live prayer together with Pastor Lai Ling and many other pastors and leaders. On the 18th of September, we will be having the Global Webinars. And this is an array of programs designed to help us to be equipped, to lead, to pioneer, and to connect with each other. So do look out for those webinars, and we love to see you at that time as well. Information on the webinars will be available at our websites. On the 19th of September, all of our HIM churches around the world will be screening the Global Service, which is a message from our HIM President, Pastor Wilson Lim. And do join us for that. From the 22nd to the 24th of September, we will be having Global Life Groups. This is the second time round that we're having Global Life Groups. We had so much positive feedback from different ones who have connected with brothers and sisters in Christ from all over the world. Do sign up and connect for the September Global Life Group. Again, the information is there on our website. On the 25th of September, we will have an amazing time of gathering together with our pastors and coordinators. This is a by invitation only event. And so pastors and coordinators, do keep your eye out for an email which will be sent on the 2nd of August. And more information will be in that email. So, brothers and sisters and friends, if you need more information, please visit our Global Equip 21 website. And you can also follow our HIM and Instagram for updates on the coming September events. Thank you for your time. God bless you. See you at Global Equip 21. Bye-bye. Hello everyone, welcome and hi. This is Pastor Dennis from Hope Kuching, and I would like to bring you some interesting news and updates that's happening in the HIM family. Many of us remembered Global Fest in March of this year, and there are so many encouraging reports and feedback, and people are really eager to come together again. So the good news is, in September of this year, we're going to have the Global Equip 21. During this time in September, we have a few programs and meetups for different ones. The first one is the Global Prayer. This will be happening from the 12th to the 16th of September. And we do invite everyone to fast and pray together as a HIM family. Daily prayer points will be published on our social media, and every day at a certain time, which you can check in the information, we will have Facebook Live prayer together with Pastor Liling and many other pastors and leaders. On the 18th of September, we will be having the Global Webinars. And this is an array of programs designed to help us to be equipped, to lead, to pioneer, and to connect with each other. So do look out for those webinars, and we love to see you at that time as well. Information on the webinars will be available at our websites. On the 19th of September, all of our HIM churches around the world will be screening the Global Service, which is a message from our HIM President, Pastor Wilson Lim. And do join us for that. From the 22nd to the 24th of September, we will be having Global Life Groups. This is the second time round that we're having Global Life Groups. We had so much positive feedback from different ones who have connected with brothers and sisters in Christ from all over the world. Do sign up and connect for the September Global Life Group. Again, the information is there on our website. On the 25th of September, we will have an amazing time of gathering together with our pastors and coordinators. This is a by invitation only event. And so pastors and coordinators, do keep your eye out for an email which will be sent on the 2nd of August. And more information will be in that email. So brothers and sisters and friends, if you need more information, please visit our Global Equip 21 website. And you can also follow our HIM and Instagram for updates on the coming September events. Thank you for your time. God bless you. See you at Global Equip 21. Bye-bye.
Good morning, church. It's great that we can praise our God Almighty, amen, because He has brought us out from the darkness into His wonderful light. Let us come together to praise our God. Hallelujah. Praise you and worship you for who you are. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. 主，今天早上我们要定睛，我们的眼目在你的十字架上。今天早上我们要将我们的信心完全的交托给你。你是我们的磐石，是我们的山寨，是我们的力量。在你里面，我们不感到害怕，我们有满满的安全感。哈利路亚，主，我们敬拜你。
主，我仰望你，我全然信靠你，自我意象能看见你心意。主，我仰望你，我帮助来自你，赐我智慧，凡事都在你手里。看见你心意，主，我仰望你。
耶稣，我们是属于你的，我们的生命是在你手里的，耶稣基督。主，我们真的是完全交托我们自己的生命在你的手中，你来掌权，你来做王。哈利路亚，主，有你在我们身旁，我们还惧怕什么呢？你就是那全能的神，你就是我们的力量，我们的保护者。主，我们满心感恩，因为我们认识你，我们有你。感谢主，天父，感谢主，奉耶稣的名我们祷告， Amen。
Hi everyone, welcome back to our online service.
Hi, 大家好，再次欢迎大家出席我们的线上崇拜。
Today we've come to the third part of our series on puzzle.
那今天我们来到了我们正道系列拼图的第三个部分。
Where we are looking at some proverbs and how it relates to relationships.
那我们将会探讨一些箴言，看看它如何对关系来说话。
We've looked at finding the right peace. The life partner.
那之前我们曾经谈到说，我们要找到那正确的拼图零片，也就是我们的伴侣。
And we also talk about pieces of the puzzle, which is about friendship.
那我们也讲到说，这个拼图的零片讲到友情。
Now today we'll be talking about the missing piece.
而今天我们将会讲到的是错失的拼图零片。
You know, when we are doing a jigsaw puzzle, and we come to the end of almost.To complete the jigsaw puzzle, it's so frustrating when there's one missing piece.
那当我们玩过拼图的人都知道，当你在拼图的时候，你拼到差不多完整的时候，你发现其中一片的拼图零片不见的时候，你会觉得非常的烦躁的。
You feel very frustrated because the picture is not complete.
你会觉得很烦躁，因为那一个图片就不完整了。
Now this is how it is in relationships.
那在关系当中，其实它也是这样的。
When we have broken relationships and someone is missing, that person is missing.
当我们有一个破碎的一段关系，然后有一些人是我们错失的。
Because of a conflict.
因着一些的冲突。
Because of a misunderstanding.
因着一些的误解。
Because of maybe some hurtful words that somebody have said.
又或者说一时口快说出的一些伤害性话语。
And that special person.
那特别的人
is missing from the equation,
就被在这公式当中错失了。
So today we'll be talking about that missing piece and how to bring that missing piece back together.
那今天我们会讲到这个错失的零片，然后如何重新找回那错失的零片。
Let's look at a few proverbs.
让我们来看几个箴言。
Proverbs 10 verse 12 and verse 8, hatred stirs up conflict, but love covers over all wrongs.Whoever conceals hatred with lying lips and spreads slander is a fool.
箴言书十章十二节和十八节里面说到，恨能挑起争端，爱能遮掩一切过犯，隐藏怨恨有说谎的嘴，口出谗言是愚妄的人。
Proverbs 17:9, whoever fosters love covers over an offense, but whoever repeats the matter separates close friends.
箴言书十七章九节，遮掩人过犯，寻求仁爱，屡次挑错，离间密友。
Proverbs 24:17-18, do not gloat when your enemy falls, when they stumble, do not let your heart rejoice, or the Lord will see and disapprove, and turn his wrath away from them.
箴言书二十四章十七到十八节说到，你仇敌跌倒，你不要欢喜。他倾倒，你心不要快乐，恐怕耶和华看见就不喜悦，将怒气将从仇敌身上转过来。
Proverbs 19:11, a person's wisdom yields patience. It is to one's glory to overlook an offense.
箴言书十九章十一节，人有见识就不轻易发怒，宽恕人的过失便是自己的荣耀。
Proverbs 25:21, if your enemy is hungry, give him food to eat.If he is thirsty, give him water to drink. In doing this, you will heap burning coals on his head, and the Lord will reward you.
箴言书二十五章二十一到二十二节，你的仇敌若饿了，就给他饭吃；若渴了，就给他水喝。因为你们这样行，就是把炭火堆在他头上，耶和华必赏赐你。
Proverbs 27:5-6, better is open rebuke than hidden love. Wounds from a friend can be trusted. but an enemy multiplies kisses.
箴言书二十七章五到六节，当面的责备强如背地的爱亲，朋友家的伤痕出于忠诚，仇敌连连亲嘴却是多余。
Let's pray.
让我们来祷告。
Father, we come before you today.
父神，我们今天来到你的跟前。
And we are here to listen to your word.
我们在这里聆听神你的话语。
God, as you speak to us, that we pray that each of our hearts will be like the good soil that will receive your word and bear fruit.
所以我们祷告神对我们说话的时候，我们的心要像好泥土一样，能够让神你的话语生根发芽成长。
Lead us as we listen today in the name of Jesus, we pray.
帮助我们能够专注的 来聆听神的话语，奉耶稣的名我们祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
So we're talking about reconciliation, finding that missing piece.
那今天我们说到了修复，也就是错失的，找回我们错失的零片。
And it has to do with conflict.
它其实就关乎于冲突。
Now, all good relationships don't just have happy times or good times.
那所有好的关系呢，它不单只是有甜美、有美好的记忆罢了。
But there are incidences that would test that relationship.
也会有一些的事件是在考验那段关系的。
Conflicts and misunderstandings, for example.
打个比方，会有冲突，会有误解。
But it's very unfortunate when relationships go sour, good relationships go sour.
但是很不幸的，有一些的关系，很好的关系，到最后的时候却败坏了。
And we don't know how to repair those relationships.
而我们也不知道要如何去修复这一些的关系。
And so it's good that we look at the Proverbs, we look at the Bible to find ways how we can repair relationships.
所以是好的，我们可以去参考圣经的箴言，我们来看如何去修复一段关系。
It's a very important part of being a disciple of Jesus Christ.
作为耶稣基督的门徒，这是很重要的一环。
That we don't just make relationships and have good relationships, just as we have covered over the past 2 weeks,But we also learn how to repair relationships that are broken or damaged.
我们不单只是要建立很好的一个关系，就好像我们过去两个星期我们说到的如何去建立关系，但是在一些破碎的关系当中，我们要学习如何去修复它。
Now the first thing is that we need to understand what are the signs that the relationship needs repair.
那首先第一点，我们需要理解到的就是关系需要修复的一些征兆。
Let me share with you 3 signs.
让我跟你们分享三个征兆。
Now the first thing is found in Proverbs 10 verse 18. It says, "Whoever conceals hatred with lying lips, and spreads slander is a fool."
这第一点可以在箴言书第十章八十八节里面看到，隐藏怨恨，有说谎的嘴，口出谗言是愚妄的人。
Now this proverb is not talking just about lying about someone.
这个箴言其实也不单只是说到说谎、撒谎罢了。
But sometimes, because we have a conflict with someone and we don't like the person, we may even speak the truth with the intent of destroying the person's name.
那有时候我们在冲突当中，因着我们的冲突，我们对那个人已经有不满了，可能我们会说一些东西，到最后是会毁掉那个人的名誉的。
So this is something for us to notice about ourselves in our relationships.
所以在一段关系当中，我们是需要注意自己的行为。
Are there people in our circle of our social circle that whenever we think of them, whenever we talk about them, we say negative things about them?
我们想一下，在我们的社交圈子当中，有一些人，当我们每一次想到他，我们每一次提到他，都是一些负面的话呢？
We have nothing good to say about them.
对他那一个人来言，我们就是没有什么好话可以形容。
When they post something good on Facebook about themselves, you always will have something to criticize them about.
当他们在社交媒体里面放一些正面的信息的时候，你就是有一些负面的东西可以找出来。
And sometimes we even exaggerate about their weaknesses.
甚至是我们可以就是能够找出他们的一些弱点。
Now this reveals that there's something wrong in our heart.
这就彰显说其中我们的心已经不正了。
That in our heart we harbor something against the person.
在我们心里面，我们蕴藏着一些对这一个人的不满。
Perhaps you are jealous about the person's achievements.
也许我们是对这一个人的嫉妒。
So the first thing is about speaking negative, slandering the person, or lying about the person.
那首先第一点就是我们可能会说一些负面的言语对于这一个人，又或者说说谎、撒谎等等。
The second thing is repeating, second thing is repeating the offense.
那么第二点就是翻旧账。
It's found in Proverbs 17 verse 9, it says, whoever would foster love covers over an offense, but whoever repeats the matter separates close friends.
在箴言书十七章九节说到，遮掩人过的寻求仁爱，屡次挑错的离间密友。
You know, as Christians, we are taught to forgive.
那作为基督徒，我们都被教导说我们需要原谅。
There was one time, a couple came to me.
那有一次呢，有一个情侣来到我这边。
And the wife kept criticizing the husband.
而这个妻子呢，就不断地去批评她的丈夫。
He's always like that. He's always like that.
他每次都是这样，每次都是这样。
But when I look at the husband, I realize that this man is a faithful man, faithful to his wife.
但是我看着这一个男人的时候，我知道说这个男人他是一个对他妻子非常忠诚的一个人。
Now he wasn't the most dashing or charming man in the world.
他可能不是那个最有魅力的一个男人在世界上。
In fact, he was a man of few words.
而且他是很沉默寡言的一个人。
Not aggressive.
也不是那一种很激进的。
But the wife was bringing up some things that was very trivial to me. They're not very very big issues.
那这个妻子呢，带出了一些的信息，其实非常的触动到我。但是也不是一个很大的事情。
He didn't pay for the children's insurance on time.
打个比方，他就是有时候忘记帮他的孩子的保险付账。
His salary is only this amount.
他的薪水可能就不够用。
He's always so passive.
然后非常的被动。
But this man, I look at him, I didn't see much wrong in him.
但是我看着这个男人的时候，我会发现说，这个人其实也没有太多的太多的错在他身上。
But the wife keep repeating the offense, repeating things again and again, even the smallest things.
但是这个妻子却不停地翻旧账，纵使那是很小很小的一些错误。
I saw a big problem in that, in the wife.
我在这个妻子身上看见一个很重要的一个问题。
So I pointed it out to her.
我就把它指出来给她看。
That you're repeating something that happened before again and again. Those are very small things.
你看，你一直一直在翻旧账，然后那一些旧账其实都是一些芝麻绿豆的小事儿。
I realized and I saw through it that she had a bigger problem of the heart.
我就跟她说，发现说她心里面有一个更大的一个问题。
Now, another sign is feeling ill will.
那其中一个是接下来的一个征兆就是心怀叵测，居心不良。
The third sign is, an ill feeling towards the person.
就是对那一个人有不良的一些居心。
Proverbs 24, 17 and 18, do not gloat when your enemy falls, when they stumble, do not let your heart rejoice, or the Lord will see and disapprove, and turn his wrath away from them.
箴言书24章17到18节说到，你仇敌跌倒，你不要欢喜，他倾倒，你心不要快乐，恐怕耶和华看见就不喜悦，将怒气从仇敌身上转过来。
So we say that we have forgiven the person.
他说到，如果我们已经原谅那个人。
But deep in our hearts, we really haven't forgiven the person if we have this kind of ill will against them.
但是我们心里面心灵深处，可能我们并没有彻底的去原谅那个人。我们对这一个人的居心还是叵测的。
It's as if we are waiting for something bad to happen to them.
就好像其实我们还在等待一些所谓的报应发生在他们的身上。
To receive some punishment.
去得到一些所谓的惩罚
to get into some trouble
让他们陷进一些的困境当中
to be scolded by superior
被上司责骂等等
and we're just hoping that something bad happens to them
我们就希望说在他们身上有报应
and then we can say yes she deserves it
然后我们就会觉得说活该
she deserves it, he deserves it
我们说这个人就活该
And that is actually there's a problem in our heart.
那其实他也彰显说，在我们心里面其实是有问题的。
There's a kind of toxic problem in our heart.
这个其实是一个非常有毒的、非常毒性非常强的一个问题在我们心里面。
The problem is not with the other person. The problem is with us.
这个问题并不在对方的身上，乃是在我们的心灵深处。
And God disapproves of this.
而耶和华对这件事情是不喜悦的。
God disapproves of us gloating over somebody's misfortune.
所以神他是不喜悦看到我们对其他人想要看见其他人的报应等等。
In fact, because of our gloating, God might even postpone or he might even remove his judgment on that person for the wrong that he done against you.
甚至是神他会将他的怒气从这一个对方的身上挪走，这个审判从对方身上挪走，转在你的身上。
So the issue is the issue of the heart.
所以这里的关键是心理的问题。
Whenever we are in conflict, of course, you know, sometimes as a church leader, we do like our church leaders, we would help reconciliation.
那么在很多的冲突当中，那尤其是在我们教会里面，我们教会很长，我们都会做修复的工作。
Because we want to see peace in the house of God.
因为我们要在神的家里面看见平安。
Now a lot of times I as somebody who is doing reconciliation, helping people reconcile, sometimes I can see that a person has not forgiven another person.
那作为帮助人家去修复关系的一个人，我常常能够看见有一些人他并没有完全彻底的去原谅对方。
They still bring up the past.
他们还是在翻旧账。
They still exaggerate the person's wrongs.
他们还在指出，还是觉得那个人的错误。
And you can still feel the ill will of that person.
我们还是能够看到说这一个人对对方的心居心是不良的。
They say they're forgiven.
他说他们原谅了。
But they block the other person on all the social media, for example.
打个比方，他们还是在社交媒体当中继续的拉黑彼此。
They say they're forgiven.
他说他们赦免了。
But they say to me that I'll never greet the person again. I've forgiven him or her, but I'll never greet him again. I don't want to be anything to do with the person.
他可能说，我已经原谅了他，但是从此我们老死不相往来，我跟这一个人一点瓜葛都没有。
Now perhaps I give a benefit of doubt. Maybe for that moment, the feelings are still very, very fresh. The wound is still fresh.
可能当下那一个感觉还是非常的新。 你受伤的那种感觉，还是那种伤害还在那里。But
I hope you know in these situations it will not be prolonged.
但是我希望说这个情况并不会继续的发展下去，继续的很持续性的发展。Because
if that is that kind of relationship is prolonged, it means that true forgiveness has not been released yet. There's a problem with your heart.
如果这种情况持续的发展的话，就意味着说你没有真正的去原谅，然后这个问题心里面的问题还在发生。So
I invite you to examine your heart.
所以我要邀请你去审查你的心。Is
there anyone that when you think of them, when people are talking about them, when you see their pictures, you suddenly feel so negative against the person?
会不会有一个人在你心中，当你每一次提到他、论及他、看到他的照片、看到他任何的东西的时候，你就对他就有很负面的想法、很负面的感觉？
It shows that something needs to be done on our part first.
他就向我们展示说，在我们的这个角色、我们自己的这个本面上，我们需要做出一些努力。We
need to have a heart cleansing.
我们需要去洁净我们的心。So
that brings me to the second point.
所以这一个也带我们去第二点了。
How to repair relationships.
就是如何去修复一段关系。Now
the first thing is we need to search our hearts.
那首先第一件事情就是我们需要审查己心。Proverbs
21 verse 2 says, A person may think their own ways are right, but the Lord weighs the heart.
在箴言书21章2节里面说到，人所行的在自己的眼中看为正，唯有耶和华衡量人心。
We might think that we are doing the right thing. We might think that we are in the right.
可能你会觉得说你在做对的事情，你是对的。And
sometimes we take things into our hands. We take revenge.
有时候我们就用我们自己的方式想要去处理，我们想要报仇。We
want to hurt the person.
我们也要以牙还牙。Maybe
not maybe not physically, but in other ways.
可能并不是在外在的一种以牙还牙，但是我们换一个方式去伤害他。We
want the person to pay for their sins.
因为我们要他付上代价。And
that is a problem of our heart.
那其实也是我们内心的一个问题。
There was one time I a life group leader, my life group leader left the church.
那有一次呢，我的小组组长呢，他离开了教会。
I felt so abandoned and betrayed.
我觉得很有一种被背叛的感觉，然后被丢弃的感觉。
And every time I saw the person, I had negative feelings inside there.
每一次我看见这一个人的时候，我就有一种负面的情绪。
It scared me.
他其实让我觉得很害怕。
Because I felt that in my heart, it was becoming toxic.
因为我能够感受到在我的心里这一份的苦毒，这一份的毒已经在发展了。
Whenever I talk to the person, I would snap at the person.
我每一次跟这个人说话的时候，我都会很盯着他看。
I'll be angry, speak in a negative tone or speak negative things to the person.
然后会说一些很负面的话语，很负面的语气。
So I came before the Lord.
所以我就来到神的跟前。
I asked the Lord to heal me.
求神来医治我。
And eventually, my heart was healed.
到最终的时候，我的心受医治。
Today, when I see the person, I don't feel that negative feelings anymore.
那今天我在看到这一个人的时候，我不再有这些负面的情绪了。
But we are cordial. We are warm to one another.
然后彼此我们可以彼此的扶持。
But search our hearts.
所以我们要审查我们的心。
Don't let it become poison that affects us.
不要让它成为一个毒，会毒害、荼毒我们的心灵。
Let the Lord be the one that search our hearts.
让主成为那个审查我们心的人。
Let the truth be God's truth, not how we feel about certain things.
让那个真理是神的真理，而不是我们对那件事的感觉。
Now, after we search our heart, the next thing is that we need to learn to overlook the offense. In Proverbs 19, verse 11, a person's wisdom yields patience. It is to one's glory to overlook an offense.
当我们去审查己心之后，我们第二个我们要做的就是人有海涵。在箴言书19章11节里面说到，人有见识就不轻易发怒，宽恕人的过失便是自己的荣耀。
So you feel that the person has hurt you.
你可能觉得说这个人伤害了你。
He said something, that hurt your feelings.
他说了一些伤害你的话语。
Or maybe he or she criticized your children.
可能他批评了你的孩子。
And you feel so offended by that.
你觉得说很被冒犯。
And this is where, as we are searching our hearts, we need to be able to learn how to overlook the offense.
所以我们当我们去审查我们的心的时候，我们要学习原有海涵。
To release forgiveness.
就是去原谅。
Now, forgiveness, some of us would think that, you know, I demand justice.
可能会有一些人觉得说我需要伸张正义。
But you know what forgiveness is?
但是他们其实也不知道真正的原谅。
Actually, forgiveness is not free of charge.
其实原谅并不是免费的。
Forgiveness comes with a price.
因为赦免、原谅其实都需要付上代价的。
Forgiveness comes with a price.
所以原谅是需要代价的。
Who pays the price?
谁付上了这个代价呢？
The person who forgives is the one who pays the price.
那一个原谅的人他付上了代价。
So some of you say it's not fair.
有人会觉得说不公平。
We demand justice, an eye for an eye, tooth for a tooth.
我们要伸张正义，以牙还牙，以眼还眼。
But Proverbs says this: it is to one's glory to overlook an offense.
但是箴言书却告诉我们，宽恕人的过失便是自己的荣耀。
It may seem that we are losing something, and truly so, we need to pay the price for our forgiveness.
可能看起来我们需要去付上一些代价，我们需要流失一些东西。
But at the same time, we are gaining something.
但是同时，其实我们是得着一切的。
Perhaps we are gaining back that relationship.
可能我们是那个赢回关系的。
Perhaps we also are learning to draw closer to God, to trust in God.
也许我们也可以赢回跟神之间的关系，我们学习如何更加的贴近神的心意。
We are also learning how God has forgiven us.
我们也学习说神如何的原谅我们。
So we need to settle in our hearts first and then release forgiveness.
然后，所以我们必须要先去审查我们的心，然后去原谅。
Is there anyone you have not forgiven yet?
是不是有一些人我们还没有去原谅的呢
？Somebody that maybe you even say with your mouth that I will never forgive him, I will never forgive her.
一些可能你曾经是信誓旦旦的说我永远都不会原谅他的人。
I invite you to release forgiveness. It will heal your heart.
我邀请你, 真的是要去发出你的原谅在他们的身上。
Now the third thing, after we learn how to forgive the person, is that to return good for evil. In Proverbs 25, verses 21 and 22, it says, if your enemy is hungry, give him food to eat. If he is thirsty, give him water to drink. In doing this, you will heap burning coals on his head, and the Lord will reward you.
那么第三点可以在箴言书二十五章二十一到二十二节里面看见，他说：“你的仇敌若饿了，就给他饭吃；若渴了，就给他水喝。因为你这样行，就是把炭火堆在他的头上，耶和华也必赏赐你。”So
you're doing something that is opposite of what the world is teaching us to do.
那其实你在做的一切，其实就是跟世界所教导的是背道而驰的。Instead
of returning evil for evil, we are returning good for evil.
那我们以取选择，以牙还牙，以眼还眼，我们还不如以德报怨。Perhaps
they mistreated us, but we are treating them good.
也许他们亏待我们，但是我们必须善待他。We
see them hungry, we see them thirsty. Instead of laughing at them or gloating at them, we give them food to eat and something to drink.
如果我们看见他饿了，我们看见他渴了，我们不要嘲笑他，我们不要幸灾乐祸，我们给他吃的，给他喝的。Let
me bring this to another level.
我们可以把它去到另外一个层面。It's
easy to pity someone who is suffering.
可能我们很容易的去那一些正在面对苦楚的人，我们很容易。But
what if your enemy is having some fortune or did well?
那如果你的这个仇敌，他不是那个受苦有苦楚的那一个，他反而是那个很繁荣、很有运气的呢？So
another way is that we celebrate together with them.
那另外一个方式就是我们跟他们同庆贺。So
how can we go about this if there's somebody that we really can't get along with?
那如果我们要如何处理呢? 如果我们真的是遇到一个我们处不来的一个人。
I remember years ago there was a person who was faithfully serving in our church.
那很多年前在教会里面有一个很忠心的一个人，很忠心服侍神的人。
But there was some reason I couldn't get along with him.
但是就是有一些原因，就是发生了一些事情。
We didn't see eye to eye on some matters.
在一些的事情上面，我们可能达不成协议。
There was so much friction that at times I felt so uncomfortable when I was in the same room with the person.
我们就发生了许许多多的摩擦，到一个地步，我就跟他共处一室的时候，我会觉得很不舒服。
In Sunday service, it was difficult to even meet eye to eye or even say things to one another.
那在崇拜的时候，如果我们看到，我们就很难能够彼此的接触。
What do you do in situations like this?
如果发生这样的一个事情的话, 你要该怎么解决呢?
But over the years, this relationship has also healed.
那在这些年, 经过了一些年岁之后, 这个情况也被医治了。And
we will not be fighting over what we fought over last time.
我们也不会像过去那样争斗了。But
perhaps there are some people like that in your life.
但是也许在你们生命当中确实也会有遇到这样的人。So
let me suggest a few things.
让我提议你几个建议。Now
the first thing is to, Jesus tells us to pray for enemies.
那首先第一样就是耶稣告诉我们说我们要为我们的仇敌来祷告。So
we can speak to God and pray for the person.
所以你可以对神来说话，我们来祷告。Don't
pray for the person for to face some sort of calamity, but pray for blessing, pray for their eyes to be open to the Lord.
我们不需要祷告说我们让那个人澄清什么这样，我们要祷告说敞开他们的眼睛，然后祝福他们。Bless
those who curse you, Jesus tells us.
圣经告诉我们说，我们要去祝福那一些咒诅你的人。So
the first thing is to pray for the person.
所以首先第一件事情，你要为对方来祷告。Now
the second thing is how we talk about the person when the person is not around.
那第二件就是当那个人不在的时候，我们要如何去应对？
We can actually send off negative things about the person.
我们可能可以讲一些对那个人负面的一些话。
So it's very important for us to, when the person is not around, to speak positively about the person, find something that the person is good at.
所以很重要的一件事情就是当那一个人不在的时候我们要说出正面对那一个人的话所以找出一些正面的地方去说
Now sometimes you have certain information that can even blackmail the person you can cause the person to really have a bad name but it is to your glory to conceal that
可能有一些时候呢，你的确在你手上，他有他们的把柄，有他们的黑料，你确实可以去说他们的一些负面的东西，但是却是你的荣耀能够去解决这个东西。
Because if it's an offense against you, it is between the two of you. It's not for everyone to hear.
因为如果他们在冒犯你的话，其实每一个人其实都能够听到。
Unless those people can help with that situation.
那除非那一些听到的人能够去帮助到整个情况改善。
So how do you how do you manage yourself in public when you're talking about the person?
所以当你在大众的时候，当别人正在论断一些人的时候，你要如何去应对处理呢？
And the third thing that we can do is that we can actually be friendly to the person.
那第三点我们可以做到的就是我们可以对那一个人对对方友善。
You can acknowledge the person when you see the person. Just greet them by name.
可能我们可以尊重他，承认他，就是单单的去以他们的名字来称呼他们，跟他们打招呼等等。
Perhaps she doesn't respond when you call her name.
也许你叫她的名字的时候，她并不回应你。
But keep trying.
你可以继续的尝试。
And maybe even on the Facebook, if they have some posts and they're still your Facebook friend, you could like some of their posts.
甚至是你可能在面子书的话，你们还是朋友的话，没有彼此拉黑的话，你还可以去赞他的一些他的文，他在上社交媒体的一些东西。
Basically, we're trying to send signals that we are friendly to them.
所以我们要让他们知道说我们对他们是友善的。
We don't hate them.
我们不恨他。
But we are making effort to restore the relationship.
并且我们正在努力，我们正在想办法想要修复这段关系。
Find opportunities to buy a meal or give a gift or something that the person will not feel so offended, but feel that you are really you have some positive feelings about the person.
找机会去请他们吃饭，买他们一些小礼物等等的，让那个人知道说，你对他已经没有任何负面的那种情绪了，甚至是比较友好的情绪了。
Verse 22 says, "In doing this, you will heap burning coals on his head, and the Lord will reward you."
在22节里面说到，因为你们这样行，就是把炭火堆在他的头上，耶和华也必赏赐你。
You're just showering so much love that the person feels so guilty that they shouldn't feel offended with you anymore. Also,
你基本上你就是觉得说，你就把那种让那种爱。用爱来浸润他们，让他们觉得说他不再被冒犯了。
Now the fourth thing is very important.
那么第四点也是很重要的一点。
Confront with love if you need to.
我们要凭信心的去处理对峙，如果需要的话。
Proverbs 27:5-6, better is open rebuke than hidden love. Wounds from a friend can be trusted, but an enemy multiplies kisses.
箴言书27:5-6说道，当面的责备强如背地里的爱情，朋友家的伤痕出于忠诚，仇敌连连亲嘴却是多余的。
Now I found that in a lot of relationship problems,
我发现说很多在关系上的问题
，just a simple clarification could solve the problem.
其实一个很简单的澄清就可以解决那个问题了。
But when we start to assume about the person, we start to accuse, then the problem escalates even more than what it actually is.
当我们开始假设，我们开始去猜测的时候，这个问题就开始升温了。
But when we clarify, and we ask questions, then we find that actually our assumptions may have been wrong.
当我们去澄清的时候，我们会发现说，其实我们的假设、我们的猜测都是错误的。
And it de-escalates the conflict with the person. We become more friendly with the person. We start to understand that person's point of view when we talk with them.
它就解决了我们当中的这个冲突，它使我们更加理解对方，让我们能够用对方的角度去思考。
Rather than going to the person, I feel so offended by what you said to me that day.
我们与其去到这一个人的面前跟他说，我很被你的话语冒犯。
We could go to the person and say, I'd like to clarify, when you said this to me, what do you mean? Do you really think I'm that kind of person?
可能你可以去到那个人的前面问他说，我想知道，我想澄清一下，你这句话是什么意思呢？你真的是觉得我是这样的一个人是吗？
And perhaps we will learn something new about ourselves. Maybe we are the problem, not the other person.
也许在当中的时候，我们就会认清我们自己的另外一面，也许我们自己才是那个问题根源，也不是对方。
A lot of problems can be resolved this way.
我们很多问题都可以被解决了。
Bible teaches us to go one-to-one to the person.
但是我们需要一对一的去对峙。
If you still feel offended,and the person has not responded by admitting wrong, maybe you might want to call another witness or not a leader who you can trust.
如果你还是觉得他这个澄清让你觉得很被冒犯的话，然后你没有得到一个很好的一个回应，那么可能你可以邀请多一个人来做你的见证人，可以邀请你的领袖做一个见证人。
And we mustn't just choose people who we think who will always be on our side.
那我们绝对不能够去选那一些永远跟我们站在同一阵线的人。
Most of the time, our leaders would try to be impartial and not to take one side or the other.
那大部分的时候呢，我们的领袖也会选择比较中立的一个立场，然后不会偏向任何一方。
Because a lot of times for me as a leader, I'll be able to see problems on both sides. So both sides will need to adjust the behavior.Or attitude. It's not just one-sided. In a lot of conflicts, it's not just one-sided. There are two sides.
那作为一个领袖，在我很多的这个情况之下，我都看见说，两方面都是需要去改变，需要去付出努力的。因为这些问题的发生，很多时候并不是一个单向的，是双方都有在贡献，一个巴掌拍不响的问题。
Of course, there are times when it's one-sided, and we will also teach the one who is a victim to also release forgiveness to, so that their hearts may be pure.
那么当然也偶尔也有一些情况的发生是只有一个单方面真的是一个单方面的错误，那么我们也会跟受害者说要去原谅，让他们的心是更加的纯洁的。
So that missing piece can come back in our lives.
使得那个错失的零片可以再次回到我们的生命。
Is there something that you could apply today?
这是有没有一些东西是你今天就可以去应用出来的
？To get going in repairing your relationships，
去修复关系。
Don't delay，
不要迟延。
Maybe it's been years and years that you'll be keeping it in your heart。
也许在你心里面，这个已经积攒了很多年了。
Why not today？
那今天
，We see a start of that the healing process。
我们能不能看到一个？医治的开始呢？
Now the third thing I want to talk about is the heart of repairing relationships.
而第三点我们要讲到的是修复关系的一个中心。
Where do we get the power to do all these things?
那我们要如何得到能量来做这一切呢？
When the world is teaching an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth.
当世界都教导我们以牙还牙，以眼还眼的时候。
And God's word, God is teaching us to forgive, which is so difficult.
而神的话语却教导我们去原谅赦免，那是非常艰难的一件事。
The key is love.
而当中的关键是爱。
Proverbs 10 verse 12 says, hatred stirs up conflict, but love covers over all wrongs.
在箴言书里面说到，恨能挑起争端，爱能遮掩一切过犯。
It is love.
那是爱。
Instead of letting our hearts be filled with hatred, anger, bitterness, fill our hearts with love.
以及让我们的心里面充满着苦毒，充满着憎恨，充满着悲伤，还不如让我们的心里面充满着爱。
A heart that is giving.
一个愿意去奉献的心。
A heart that can forgive.
愿意去原谅的心。
And overcome, and overlook wrongs.
能够去原谅的一颗心。
And so where do we get that power from?
然后我们从哪里支取这个力量呢？
That power comes from the Lord.
而这个力量的来源是主。
It is God who first demonstrated His love to us.
因为是神，他首先向我们展示他的爱。
When yet we are still sinners, Christ died for you and me.
因为我们还在做罪人的时候，神就为我们死了。
We would need to atone for our own sins, but we can't.
我们应该是要为我们的罪付上代价的，但是我们不能。
And all of us are headed for judgment.
我们每一个人都需要被审判。
Because God is a fair God.
因为我们的神是公义的神。
God is the greatest accountant.
他是那个我们最终的那个我们需要交账的人。
Every sin needs to be accounted for. Every offense needs to be accounted for.
每一个罪，每一个很小的一件事情，我们都需要交账。
But Jesus took all our sins on the cross.
但是耶稣却把我们所有的罪带上了十字架。
He paid the price to forgive. So forgiveness is costly. It cost God His only Son Jesus.
然后耶稣在十字架上为我们的罪付上了代价，所以原谅是需要代价的。但是耶稣为我们付上了那份代价。
Because we have seen that love from God.We too will also we and we receive that forgiveness. We too receive release forgiveness to others.
那因着我们从神那里领受了那一份爱，我们从神那里接受了这一份爱，这一份原谅，所以我们也要把我们的原谅释放，我们去原谅其他的人。
When we realize the price that God has paid for us,
当我们能够意识到耶稣他付上的这个代价
，When we realize how much.Evil, how much sins we have committed in our lives.
当我们能够意识到我们生命当中的邪恶，我们生命当中所犯的罪。
Yet when we come to the Lord, He forgives us.
但是我们来到神的跟前的时候，他原谅我们。
When we repent, He forgives us.
我们悔改，他原谅我们。
And if we so need that forgiveness,
我们何等需要这一份的原谅。
How much more the ones who have offended us?How much more the ones who has offended us?
不，那些被我们冒犯我们的人也需要。
Especially when they are seeking for forgiveness.
尤其是那一些他们正在等待。
Do not withhold forgiveness.
他那一些等待被原谅的。
Give it unconditionally, as the Lord has forgiven us unconditionally.
我们要无条件的去原谅，因为我们的神也是无条件的原谅我们。
Matthew 5 verse 9 says this, Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God.
在马太福音5章9节里面说到，使人和睦的人有福了，因为他们必称为神的儿子。
We thank God that God is our Father.
我们感谢神，因为他是我们的主。
And we are His children.
我们是他的孩子。
But how do we know that we are God's children?
但是我们怎么知道我们是神的孩子呢？
One sure sign is this, they are peacemakers.
那其中一个征兆让我们看，我们知道说我们是神的孩子，就是我们是那和平之子。
We make peace with others.
我们使人和睦。
But we also channels of bringing peace to those in conflict.
我们也把那些平安带到冲突当中。
So maybe there's conflict in your family or in the workplace, and the conflict is not with you, but there's conflict there. Pray for peace to come upon the family and your workplace.
那也许在你的工作场所或者在你的家庭当中有发生冲突，纵使那个冲突不涉及你，你还是可以祷告说这些的神的平安要介入在这个冲突当中。
And we really love to see that the whole picture, the whole jigsaw puzzle, there'll be no missing pieces.
我们真的是很渴望看见一个完整的拼图是完整的呈现出来，没有任何错失的鳞片。
In our life groups, in our church, in our families.
在我们的小组，在我们的教会，在我们的家庭。
So let's pray that broken relationships will be restored and healed.
所以让我们祷告说，所有破碎的关系可以再一次被修复。
As we end today.
当我们今天做总结时。
Let's pray.
让我们一起祷告。
Father, we thank you so much for all these words of wisdom that comes from you.
父神，我们为这一些从神你而来的话语，从神你而来的智慧而谢恩。
And we pray that you will search our hearts, O God.
我们祷告说神，你要审查我们的心。
We open our hearts to you.
我们敞开我们的心给你。
And search our hearts.
审查我们的心。
Is there any bitterness in our hearts?
是否有任何的苦毒在我们里面？
Is there any hatred in our hearts?
是否在我们心里面藏有一些的憎恨
against anyone?
对于任何一个人
And we pray that you will heal us.
我们祷告说神你要医治我们
And just as you have taught us, Jesus, you taught us to bless our neighbors, bless our enemies.
就好像神已经在圣经里面教导我们的，我们要祝福我们的仇敌。
Today we bless our enemies, those who have offended us or those who have ill feeling against us.
那今天我们要祝福我们的仇敌，那一些曾经冒犯过我们的，又或者那一些对我们居心不良、心怀叵测的。
And we pray that our relationship with them will be restored as well.
我们祷告说，我们跟他这些仇敌的一些关系可以被修复。
Restore broken relationships in families.
我们求神你修复在家庭当中破碎的关系
Restore broken relationships in the workplace
修复在职场上面破碎的关系
Restore relationships that have been broken for many years
修复那一些已经破碎了很多年的关系
In each of our lives
在我们每一个人的生命当中
And all this we pray in the name of Jesus
这一切都奉耶稣的名我们祷告
Thank you Lord Jesus
感谢主耶稣
Amen
Amen
Amen. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Amen. 谢谢大家参与我们今天的崇拜。
Please stay on for the announcements.
请大家留守我们的报告。
And we hope to see you again very soon.
我们希望很快的就可以跟大家再次见面。
God bless you.
神祝福大家。
Good day, church.
教会早安。
We hope you have been encouraged and blessed by the sermon today.
我们希望说你被今天的正道祝福鼓励。
Indeed, to reconcile, we need to identify, take steps to repair, and finally, bind it all in love.
没错，如果我们要修复的话，那么我们需要确认问题，采取行动去修复，最后我们以爱来解决。
Next week, Pastor Dennis will preach the fourth and last topic of our sermon series, Puzzled, called Connecting the Pieces.
下个星期 ,Dennis 牧师也会将为我们的正道系列做一个总结，关乎于连接。拼图鳞片
Stay tuned
敬请期待
Now, I would like to invite us to give to the Lord
那现在我要邀请大家奉献于我们的主
You can either give through online bank transfer, Sarawak Pay, or Maybank QR Pay
你可以透过线上转账 Sarawak Pay 或者 Maybank QR Pay 来给予奉献
We give to show our gratitude and thanksgiving to God who provides for us
我们奉献是因为我们要感恩我们的神为我们所提供的一切。
Thank you for giving faithfully to the Lord.
感谢你忠心地给予我们的主。
On the 24th of August at 8 p.m., we'll be having Prayer Hub online.
在8月24号晚上8点，我们将会举行线上的祷告会。
The theme for this Prayer Hub is extravagant love.
而这个祷告会的主题是奢华的爱。
Let us focus our hearts on Jesus and His love.For the upcoming prayer hub.
在这个祷告会当中，让我们专注我们的心于耶稣基督和他的爱。
See you there.
我们到时见。
Lastly, we will also be having HIM Global Equip 2021 from the 12th to the 25th of September.
那最后，我们也将会有一个希望国际施工全球的装备于9月12日的到25日。
There will be a global prayer, global webinar, global service,Global Life Group and a Pastors and Coordinators segment all throughout the equip.
届时我们将会有全球祷告会、全球网络研讨会、全球崇拜、全球小组以及牧师和协调门人的这些音频等。
This will be a great time to reconnect with our hope brothers and sisters from all around the globe.
这将会是一个美好的时刻，让我们与全球的弟兄姐妹们重新连接。
For more information, you can visit the Global Equip 21 website.
更多的详情你可以参考全球装备的网站。
That's all for our announcements today.
今天的报告到此为止。
Thanks for joining us. May God give you a blessed week ahead.
谢谢你参与我们，也求神祝福你有蒙福的一个星期。
Bye bye.
再会。
Hello everyone, welcome and hi, this is Pastor Dennis from Hope Kuching and I would like to bring you some interesting news and updates that's happening in HIM family. Many of us remembered Global Fest in March of this year and there are so many encouraging reports and feedback and people are really eager to come together again. So the good news is, in September of this year, we're going to have the Global Equip 21. During this time in September, we have a few programs and meetups for different ones. The first one is the Global Prayer. This will be happening from the 12th to the 16th of September. And we do invite everyone to fast and pray together as a HIM family. Daily prayer points will be published on our social media. And every day at a certain time, which you can check in the information, we will have Facebook Live prayer together with Pastor Lai Ling and many other pastors and leaders. On the 18th of September, we will be having the Global Webinars. And this is an array of programs designed to help us to be equipped, to lead, to pioneer, and to connect with each other. So do look out for those webinars, and we love to see you at that time as well. Information on the webinars will be available at our websites. On the 19th of September, all of our HIM churches around the world will be screening the Global Service, which is a message from our HIM president, Pastor Wilson Lim. And do join us for that. From the 22nd to the 24th of September, we will be having Global Life Groups. This is the second time round that we're having Global Life Groups. We had so much positive feedback from different ones who have connected with brothers and sisters in Christ from all over the world. Do sign up and connect for the September Global Life Group. Again, the information is there on our website. On the 25th of September, we will have an amazing time of gathering together with our pastors and coordinators. This is a by invitation only event. And so pastors and coordinators, do keep your eye out for an email which will be sent on the 2nd of August. And more information will be in that email. So, brothers and sisters and friends, if you need more information, please visit our Global Equip 21 website. And you can also follow our HIM and Instagram for updates on the coming September events. Thank you for your time. God bless you. See you at Global Equip 21. Bye-bye.